Sometimes we'll have a design like this contact page, which doesn't really take up the height of the viewport. So when we add a footer to this, it just kind of sits there. This happens a lot on larger screens. So what's our goal in this video? We're going to make this footer, you can copy and paste this one we made into your own project. We're going to make it stay at the bottom, but it'll also respect additional content above it. What does that mean? If we had the full text of Dostoevsky's Crime and Punishment, the footer still stays at the bottom. So we'll do this by configuring our body all pages tag. We'll set the margin on the footer itself. Then we'll cover how to make the footer a symbol so we can use it on other pages. Let's start with the body all pages tag. And this is a special tag because when we modify this, it affects the body element on all pages. Hence the name, body all pages. So let's select our body and we'll click into our selector field and select body all pages. We'll do two things. Let's set the display to flex. We want to use flexbox. And the second thing, we want items inside the body to stack vertically. And that's it. That's step one. Step two is even simpler. The footer, the one that's been on the screen this entire time, we're going to select it. And because we set its parent element, because we set the body to flexbox, we can set the top margin on the footer element to auto. This is the number one invention in the history of the world. That's it. Notice how the div block, our footer, is automatically pushing itself off the content above. Now, what happens if we have more content? We'll cover this as we move to number three, reusing it in a symbol on other pages. And we have another page in this project. We created another page, a portfolio, and there's clearly more content on the page. It takes up way more vertical height. So instead of copying and pasting the footer, let's go back to the original page where we first created this footer and we'll select the footer itself. And to create a symbol, let's right click on the footer's label, on the label itself. All we have to do is press create symbol. And we can name it anything we want, like footer. And now that it's a symbol, we can reuse it anywhere. So if we go back to that other page, we can add that symbol just like we'd add another element. In the add panel, we see symbols here. And we can just drag the footer symbol we created. We'll make sure it's inside the body element and underneath everything else. And as for its placement on the page, notice how it respects the other content and it hasn't created additional white space above it. That white space or blank space will only be created if it's needed, if the content on the page isn't tall enough to push the footer to the bottom. So, here's what it looks like on that kind of page. Here's what it looks like on the second page with more content, except we can't see it because we have to scroll down. So we set our body all pages tag to flexbox with a vertical direction. We set our footer's top margin to auto and we made the footer a symbol. That way we can reuse it on multiple pages. Now, the other great thing about a symbol, if we make a change to that symbol on any one page, it automatically updates. That change will affect all instances of that symbol throughout the project. But that's using flexbox, top margin, and alchemy to create a footer that does what we want it to do.